Giro d'Italia for 1985.
Here we're looking at them 15 kilometers from the finish.
And altogether, predictably, after a flat stage, even though it is some 140 miles or more in length,
totally flat, and we have a compact group. The Colombians, by the way, had a team in this Giro, but it seems like it was almost too flat for them in stages. They would do well when the road started going up, but they would take a beating on these flat stages because they just don't have the 35, 40 miles an hour on their legs, and they just sometimes they would actually get dropped on some of these flat portions, or else they might get dropped in the flat portion, get up to a hill, then work their buns off to get to the top of the hill with the leaders, and then to lose it in the descent and in the next flat portion. The Colombians traditionally have had some difficulty in Europe, particularly on the flats. They have no problems with the hills. They're used to worse hills than anything that they have in Europe. They just have a lot of difficulty with the speed and the flats.
By contrast, the Dutch riders, who have absolutely no mountains or hills to climb whatsoever in their entire country, are able to train themselves to climb well because it takes very much of the same ability to be able to go 35 miles an hour on the flats. If you're small and light, the same kind of power can be applied in a lower gear to go up hills. The Colombians just don't have any flat places to train on, and they therefore have not developed the horsepower. It's just a question of horsepower. Many of the Colombian riders are very, very small, very slightly built, and just don't have the raw power it takes to go fast on flat ground.
Here we have the rider setting up for the sprint.
And it's going to be another wild one, it appears, with riders wall to wall going into a almost a hairpin turn to the finish. And headlights flashing, the caravan comes to the finish line after nearly 6 hours. You can see the running time at 5:48 and a half. And here's the dash.
Rosola and Bontempi second. By the way, these two riders are from the same town. Rosola rides for Bianchi and Bontempi rides for Carrera Inoxpran, and they